twinkle, twinkle little spatula. I just got done with work and grocery shopping. Working at a grocery store, it's hard to decide. Do you finish your shift when you're exhausted and sweaty and just want to go home and do your grocery shopping? Or do you come on your day off and be at your work on your day off and do your grocery shopping? So I've been trying to kind of figure out a balance and doing whatever works better that week. And this week it just worked better to go right after work today. So that's what I did. And in today's grocery haul, you will see a full week's worth of groceries for our family of five. We have three girls and mom and dad in our household. And this week we have a special birthday celebration planned, and it's mine. So I will show you how we plan to celebrate that in our food purchases. And also later on the video, you will see Zhaina making some Rice Krispie treats. So stick with us and I hope you enjoy. So this week what I wanted to do is show you the menu that I always have hanging up on the side of our fridge. And so I just took it down and wanted to give you a brief kind of overview of what we plan to eat this week. And then we can go straight into the groceries. So this flat leaf parsley here is what you need to make Greek spaghetti the Stacy way, and I will link that either down below in the description, or if I can figure it out, I'll link it here on the screen, because I've got a tutorial for you that I already know some of my viewers have made successfully at home. So that's for the Greek spaghetti. Everything else that we need, we already have in our pantry and fridge. So that was a no-brainer for this week. And then these two items here, the spinach and the green onion, are for the Korean beef bowls and everything else we already have. So again, a no-brainer. And then all of this fancy stuff, the Oreos, the cucumber, the honey ham, the cheese, raspberries, blueberries, strawberries, cherry tomatoes, and Stacy's pita chips. All of that is for my birthday picnic tomorrow that we are going to be taking at Gooseberry Falls up here in northern Minnesota. We're going to take a little car ride, the whole family, and I will make sure to film some of that for you guys. Funny story about these Stacy's pita chips. About, I don't know, maybe 13 years ago, maybe 14 years ago, I got a box in the mail, a humongous box addressed to me, filled with Stacy's pita chips, and they were brand new at the time. I had never heard of them, and there was a cute little letter in the box, and it said that the owner of the company had sent a big box of pita chips to everybody in the country whose first name was Stacy. So if your name is Stacy and you received that box in, I think it was either 2006 or 2007, comment below and tell me your story, because I thought that was really fun and I always try to support that company because of that. So those will be that. Everything here is going to be for our picnic lunch tomorrow at Gooseberry. The Brussels sprouts and the sweet potato are for that hash that I told you about my last grocery haul. And I Instagrammed it and asked if you guys wanted me to film that, and it was an overwhelming response of yes. So I will do that for you coming up soon here. And everything else that I need is already in my fridge, so that's pretty easy. And this week it's not on my dinner menu because I'm actually going to be making it for a meal prep lunch, because it can be lunch, brunch, lunch, breakfast, dinner. It can be any meal. It is so good and versatile. And then these items here are going to be for my work lunch over the weekend. I plan to make little wraps using the buffalo chicken, which is on sale this week, and it's my favorite deli meat. And so I like to say that Super One was giving me a little happy birthday present with that. Anyways, I'm going to make little wraps with the buffalo chicken breast and spinach and hummus. They're gonna be like little gluten-free wraps, and then I'm gonna have carrots and either hummus dipping sauce, or maybe I'll put some tzatziki, and that'll be my work lunches for the weekend. Hot dogs, because we're out of them for the babies. They love those. I never buy these frozen chicken breasts. Never, ever, never, 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 ever. But I should have taken a picture, because our meat department at work was totally out of chicken. I guess they did not get any of the chicken that they ordered.
And so it was either buy something else or buy these. And I just decided to buy these because I plan on having Chad cook one night this week. He was supposed to last week, but he didn't. I pinch hit for him. So I'm trying to get him to this week. So I wanted to make sure the menu was easy. I'm just going to have him grill up some of these. And then we have some pretzel buns in the freezer and we'll make little chicken sandwiches. He can make a quick, easy honey mustard. And then I don't remember what I said we were going to have on the side. Oh, a salad. I've been, teaching him how to chop up a salad too. So I think that's something doable that he can do. So let's hope so. And then back here, this is the milk. The 1% is for everybody in the family except for me, and Zhaina. And Zhaina drinks the whole milk on the right. And I drink almond milk, which I still have some from last week. And then these items here are the only things that Zhaina needed to make my birthday cake. She's using a recipe out of the, what is it, Betty Crocker cookbook. It's a chocolate cake and I think a fudge chocolate frosting. And she only needed this corn syrup. And then I bought these numbers because it's my 39th birthday for the top of the cake. So I'll make sure to show you that. And then the big fiesta will be for tomorrow for my birthday. For dinner, Zhaina is going to be making steak fajitas. So this is everything that she needs to make those. I bought these bell peppers because they were on sale again. Sometimes I make my own guacamole and sometimes I buy it. So this week I bought it. I know this brand, this holy guacamole is really good. So it was on sale. And then those are my favorite onions that I always buy. I bought this cheese. I don't like cheese on my fajitas, but I think everybody else does. So I bought a Mexican blend. And then this is the picante that everybody else likes. And we still have some of the medium that I can choose. This is a Nummy brand of tortillas that we will use. And I think, yep, that's everything that Zhaina needed for those. And then this chocolate milk in the back, I've never bought the shelf one, but the refrigerator one is the one I usually buy and they didn't have it. And I plan on doing this, I guess you can call it a diet, calorie counting. I need to drop some weight. So this is a treat that I like when I'm doing that. And so I'm gonna try the shelf one. And if you're wondering, I'm not starting that until after my birthday. So I will get to enjoy my birthday and cake and all of that without calorie counting. So. Okay, moving on. Zhaina asked for milk chocolate chips. She likes to make mug cookies for herself for a treat on the weekend. And then this is for the Mississippi pot roast. I think I mentioned it in another video that it was a recipe that I kind of had on the back burner that I want to try. And I have the roast in my freezer and this is all I needed to buy to make that. And these two ingredients here, Zhaina also requested because we've been making special little trips up to Dunkin' Donuts and getting a drink called the Caramel Craze. And Zhaina wants to try to make that at home so she can enjoy it more often. So I bought those for her. And then this yogurt is my favorite brand of Greek yogurt. And I use this to make I think it's a Weight Watchers cheesecake, like cheater cheesecake. It actually calls for the 0% fat Greek yogurt, but honestly, you guys, that one's like not good at all, and it's not worth the like 30 less calories because it's gross. So get the 2% and get a couple more calories because it's delicious. And these are the like, you know, pantry things that we were just out of that I needed. That's the olive oil that I've showed you before. It was on sale. It's actually, I've been pretty happy with it. It's not super high quality, it's not low quality, but it's actually really good for a really good price. And then this is my favorite brand of black pepper. These two items here are the only things that Chad requested from the store. That's his diet, guys. I mean, he'll eat everything I make and then this kind of stuff. So that's that. And then these two items here, this broccoli, and I needed this pan because one of the moms in my mom church group just had her third baby, but the fifth child in their family, because her husband has two kids from a previous marriage, and they had their first girl together, and then the first girl in a really long time, because their oldest is also a girl, well, his oldest. So that's a pretty exciting thing. And we do a meal train for all new babies that are born in our group. And I already have a baked macaroni prepared, so I needed a vessel to put it in so that she won't need to worry about returning any cookware to me. So I needed to buy that. And then the side is going to be this broccoli. And I was actually looking for a much bigger bag, but frozen vegetables have been really slim pickings at my store. I don't know if that's like that around the country or just my store, but I just got this little bag for them. And then, I don't know, I'm going to do like some sort of crunchy topping on top of the baked macaroni. I haven't really decided yet. So that's everything. This grocery haul this week came to $157. Again, that's for 7 days. And this is breakfast, lunch, and dinner for the family. Keeping in mind that we do get the school bus lunches from our district because school is out. The kids walk to the bus every day and get a lunch. So it's just me and Chad that need lunch, and breakfasts I already have everything for, and we can even get a couple desserts out of this. So I thought I did really well this week because I kept $40 still in the bank for if we need to go back for anything, or maybe we decide that we want to have a little bit of a treat this week and order from somewhere. We've been trying to support the local restaurants and keep them in operation. So, all right, that's everything. And next up, you're gonna be seeing Zhaina in the kitchen making some Rice Krispie Treats. Very classic and delicious.
Welcome to our channel, Twinkle Twinkle Little Spatula. I'm Stacy's eldest daughter, and I'm going to be making Rice Krispie Treats today. We're gonna be halving the recipe because we ended up not getting enough marshmallows. And so we're gonna get started. And first, what you're gonna do is you're gonna melt your butter and then later on add the marshmallows. So I'll see you then. So the butter and the marshmallows are totally melted and it looks very goopy, and I'm sure it's super sticky. And we took it off the heat. And so now we're gonna add the Rice Krispies. So I didn't, in the bag of marshmallows, there's 48, and that was more than half of 72, which is how many marshmallows I needed. And so I just added all the marshmallows, so I'm not gonna do exactly half of the Rice Krispies either. I'm gonna do 5 cups, which is, I'm guessing, in about the same ratio of 48 to 72. So I'm gonna add the...
Just leave it in there. While you're doing that, Zhaina, tell us what made you think of making Rice Krispie Treats?
Well, we have this bus because, you know, of quarantine, the school no longer feeds you because we're not at school. So we have this bus that comes into our neighborhood. And drops off lunches and breakfast. And sometimes they add treats. And they had Rice Krispie Treats a few times, and I kept thinking, oh, these are so good. And so after the second time that they brought them, I was like, you know, maybe I should make Rice Krispies. So this is what it looks like once we've incorporated the marshmallows and the Rice Krispies. It was kind of hard, so I wouldn't recommend using a rubber scraper. Maybe use something more solid so that it isn't so flimsy. And all we're gonna do is press it into a square pan and let it cool, and then it's ready to serve. Taking the Rice Krispies out of the pot and put it into the pan, and all you have to do now is flatten it, and then you're gonna let it cool. And then you can cut it up, and then it'll be all ready.
Where's the band-aids?
Do you remember the first time you ever had Rice Krispies?
No, but when I was really, really young, I would get them all the time. Like, we would go to the doctor, and you know, they have those vending machines. I would always ask for the Rice Krispie bars. And they were, you know, they were huge in my head, so it was like great.
This is the same as room. Mommy.
Do you guys like your new swing?
Yeah. That belly press.
Did he?
And you helped, remember?
Okay.
singing?